If you've just bought and installed the game, this is how your game will look like. There's a lot going on in this scene. This is actually a hole. Here's an enemy villager trashing us, and we have an idle villager. Unfortunately, the unadjusted game visuals don't make it very easy for us to see these things. But in this video, I will show you how to change the way your game looks from this to this. We'll be accomplishing it by changing some settings and installing some mods. First, let's head on over to the graphics settings, found in the game options. To reach the settings we want to change, we first need to tick this box, allowing us to see them. There are 8 settings we want to ensure are disabled. Animate fog border, animate fog, bloom, depth of field, map lighting, vignette, beach waves, and 3D water. These are beauty settings, which essentially means that their sole function is to make things harder for you to see. They make things shinier, shakier, darker, lighter, blurrier, foggier, and they mess with the colors. Now, when we've adjusted the graphics, we head on over to the Game tab and enable this new nifty feature called Building Range Indicator. Now, we are done with the settings. Next, we need to add a few mods. I won't go through exactly how to install mods in this video, but if you are in need of such a guide, in the end of the video I link you a tutorial which shows exactly how to do it. We need to install the following 7 mods: Idle Villager Icon Highlight, Idle Villager Pointer, Small Trees, Fish Border, No More Plants, No Stumps, and Zetnus Improved Grid Mod. Remember to restart the game after installing new mods to ensure that they start working. And we are done! This is now how the game looks like. The hole in the wall is now clearly visible. We can see that there is a vacant tile now when we have the grid mod. The bushes which covered it have completely disappeared, since they were just useless decorations we couldn't even gather wood from. This tree was previously so huge that it obscured the view of the hole. The small trees mean that the upcoming trash from the enemy is not completely camouflaged either. Remember that you're never forced to watch tricky player colors. In any point of the match, you can hold Alt and press G for friends or foe colors. This will make you blue, all allies yellow, and all enemies red. There is actually a hole here as well. You can go exploring for more tree mods, which change things even more radically if you like. We can now see our idle villager, who is also emphasized with an exclamation point over her. Having idle villagers is also now more noticeable, with an attention-grabbing red instead of the old yellow, which blended in more. If we were looking for fish, we could now immediately spot where it is. Previously we had to squint to look for the fishes or even randomly click the water. The Zetnus grid mod also only displays the grid on land, unlike the official terrain grid offered in the game's options. The range indicator tells us exactly where the danger zone of the upcoming tower is. Stumps, another decorative feature, have also been removed. It's quite fascinating how cluttered things can get in the original game look. I put these 6 circles here and polled my YouTube subscribers on how many circles they thought contained wood. The vast majority was not able to tell accurately. This is wood. These are unchoppable decorations. If you found this video helpful or enjoyable, don't forget to give it a thumbs up. Do let me know in the comments if you have any other mod recommendations or thoughts. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.